What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Ari. Welcome back to AMI Live. Hope you guys are doing good. I'm doing right there. We're back with another reaction video, man. You know we live in the react. Hold on. Let me bring it back a little bit. You know, he was rocking the live gang. Ah, you know, that's my little live sign. Alright, today we're here reacting to the top things you should never do in the UK. Shouts out to all of you UK people. You know, we always gotta rock it. Let me see. God. How do you love singing? Girl. No, I gotta sing like how the Methodists used to sing when I used to go Methodist. Because I went to Methodist. God save our gracious queen. Long live our noble queen. God save our queen. I went to a Methodist school, so that's how I used to sing it. Bro, we had to sing that every Monday morning, bro. The whole vibe. And yo, you can't mask. No, wait, we used to do this. Straight, head forward. Straight, stiff. Plywood, just like that. But we have to, first we have to sing that, then we have to sing the national. Oh, we so this land of us. Okay. This ain't a Tracy Cake, this is a UK one, alright? But if you guys are new to the channel, man, smash that like button, subscribe, comment down below. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers. Help your boy get there, man. We almost there. I know you guys will do it. UK, shouts out to you. So we're gonna see what the top 10 things, Duppy must be walking outside. Top things, wait, let me stop saying that. Top 10 things to do in the, you should never do in the UK, alright? Let's get into it.
Let's start by saying that in no way are we trying to scare you away from visiting the UK. But if you are a tourist,
that's my cousin,
or an international student in the UK, then wouldn't it be better to know a few things that could offend people there? We mean, you don't want to hurt anyone with your actions or words,
man,
let alone
taking a shot at anybody long would offend them.
People would understand that you may take a while to adjust to the new surroundings and customs.
I'd spray you with a hose.
If you want to save yourself from embarrassing situations as a newcomer in the UK, we have compiled a list of things that you should avoid doing there. Number one, calling the United Kingdom England. Before you take the flight to anywhere in the UK,
hey! That's a good damn question. Don't call it England. Okay, I know United Kingdom is Ireland, Scotland, Wales, you know, the whole island and the masses, right? That's the United Kingdom. Great Britain is the country itself where the Queen, you know, the Queen live and whatever, right? Where the hell is England? Why? So the dude just said he can't call. So where the hell is England? It's great. Okay, before you take the you take that for the United Kingdom. United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. Oh! That's crazy. Let me watch the video.
UK stands for the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. Do you realize what this means? The UK consists of four countries: Scotland, England, Northern Ireland, and Wales. Moreover, each country has its own distinctive culture, national identity, and government. So before you begin your sentence with England's landscapes are, confirm that you really are in England and not Scotland, which is a separate country.
Okay, yeah, I get that.
Ask if they know the Queen. How would you feel if some tourist in the U.S. asked if you knew Donald Trump? You'd call that person plain stupid for assuming that everyone breathing the U.S. air knows the president. So how do you expect people in the U.K. to personally know the royal family? More than 60 million people live in the U.K., and over 8 million of those
live in Great Britain.
There is no way these people know their monarch more than the internet knows. You won't offend people with this question, but will definitely make them laugh. In your face. Number three, block the escalator. Escalators are common in most countries, and we don't give much thought about the do's and don'ts while we are standing on it. Well, you'd be surprised to know that there is indeed a wrong way to stand on an escalator, at least in the UK. It is an unspoken rule in this part of the world that if you want to stand still, you should stay on the right-hand side. Why? Well, the left-hand side of the escalator is reserved for those people who are in a hurry. You know, the lot who believed that by running through the escalator and saving about 30 seconds, they would get to their destination on time. Just remember, if you don't want to be pushed past, then stay on the right.
I'll push back. Y'all didn't know me.
A queue. Many of us don't give much importance to a queue. You know, the ones we see outside a dessert kiosk. Because, well, an ice cream craving can't wait. But don't do that while you're in the UK, simply because that is bad manners. Even if you think it is a petty thing and shouldn't annoy anyone, you aren't doing it here. Before you attempt any such adventure, know that those people ahead in the queue came here first and deserve to be served
first. Nah, bro, you deserve to get slapped.
Why do you want any inconvenience in the form of a fight? Stay in the queue, wait for your turn, and all will go swiftly. Number 5. Pick up a rented car. We don't mean to say that driving in this country is illegal, but you can get yourself and others in trouble by driving. We have created a nice bit of suspense here. We deserve a pat on the back. Jokes aside, the thing is that you will have to drive on the left side of the road here. And if you come from a nation where the opposite is the norm, you might have a tough time learning this.
You guys tried to see me here.
Such experiments are the last thing you should be doing, right? Plus, remember, you don't know your way around, so you'd be consulting maps on a busy road while getting used to driving on
GPS.
The wrong side. Number 6. Talk about money. You don't ask someone how much they earn or how much money they have in their pocket unless they're family or very close friends, right? Come on, that's basic decency.
Right.
People in the UK might feel offended if you ask too many questions about money. In fact, boasting about your wealth is also not going to be appreciated. So keep $50 in your pocket. Number 7, greet inappropriately. Meeting someone for the first time and experiencing that awkward situation where you go for a hug while the other stops you with a handshake. Ever been there?
No.
If you don't want to find yourself in that situation in the UK, just go for a handshake.
The most awkward introduction I ever met was this.
Physical contact with strangers. Hugging and kissing on the cheek is reserved for people they know well and are comfortable with. Oh, and what do you say when someone asks you, "How are you?" By no means is this a cue that you can start off your saga of nasal allergies if you don't want the person to never see your face again. Every how are you is followed by fine, thank you, and nothing else.
Yep.
Number 8. Fake their accent. No matter how many times you have practiced the British or Scottish accent, don't use it, because it probably isn't that good. People aren't going to like it if you force their accent, and especially... You will make it look like you aren't a part of them and are desperate to lose your identity and mix with them. Wouldn't it be better if you first make friends with natives of Wales and then try a Welsh accent?
Welsh.
Number 9. About Brexit. We know that Brexit is the topic of discussion in pretty much the entire world.
Yep.
But you can't be walking around spitting your views about it when you are in the UK. People there are directly related to it, and your views can be taken personally. And what happens when someone takes your casual opinion personally and in a negative light?
That's big bro.
They get offended and might beat you up. Maybe we went too far with the beating up part.
Yeah,
but
you're right.
Still don't want to risk it. Number 10. Mess with the Queen's Guard.
The Queen Guard is coming!
The Queen's Guard isn't your friend, and you aren't forgetting that. You may fool around with him a bit, and he won't pay much attention, let alone punish you. But there is a line drawn, and you must never cross it, because the consequences won't be pretty. Never, we repeat, never touch the guard. Because once you do that, prepare yourself for a world of hurt. Do you want that gun, the one that was fascinating you, to be pointed at you? If not, maintain a respectable distance from the guard. He deserves it. How was your experience in the UK? Tell us in the comments section below.
I like to.
Subscribe to our channel if you like this video.
The Queen Guard is coming down the street. Move out the kingdom. Do not touch the Queen's Guard. I think we did a reaction video so for them just pushing the shit out of people that they walk in their way. I ain't gonna lie. I think I enjoyed that part. Yeah. Like, don't touch me, nigga. Don't do that. I'll slap you. I said I'm gonna do my job. You can't put your hands on my... Boy! I haven't even said the Queen's Guard. I said, do not touch Ari. Don't touch Ari. Please, don't. You know, and I think I'm too short. You know, all the Queen's Guard, everybody look the same height. Everybody look like they're at least 6'1", 6'2". You know what I mean? Which is strange. I think I'm too short and fat for that. But anyway, hope you guys enjoy this, man. UK. I love you guys, man. I really do. I like the culture. It's weird. It's a good weird, though. It's a good weird. Don't think it is. insult. It's a good weird. It's like a poodle. What the hell are you? You know what I mean? Like, why are you so fluffy? I don't know. Poodle just came on my mind. Poodles are weird, bro. Like, really. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, man. If you guys are new to the channel, man, smash that like button, subscribe, comment down below. My battery's about to die, so I have to talk quick so it won't cut off in front of me. But until we meet again, man, guys, just be happy, be blessed, road to 1,000 subscribers, and remember, the world is yours. Peace.